Hello and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Hearts of Iron 4 as Yugoslavia. Today we're gearing up for war with our neighbor Romania. And we've got free civilian factories. Okay. Let's build stuff there. Oh, this is going to be very, very interesting. Let's see how this goes. I think we're going to have to up conscription, but I'm going to wait to do that until a little bit later. Because I don't want to lower the recruit times. We need better support weapons. Production. Am I building the latest stuff? Yes. Are we using all our factories? Yes, we are. Do we have any planes? We have an air force. Oh, that's kind of cool. Yeah, all of you get over there. All right. Oh, that's all one province anyways. That's cool. Oh, and I guess we have no choice now but to declare war. Oh, this is gonna hurt. If we lose, it's not the end of the world. Actually, it's probably the end of this Let's Play, though. Okay. Ooh, okay. Let's see, how does this go? Give super aggressive instructions as well. Okay, you halt that then if you're not comfortable going forward. I'm gonna let the computer do this because I don't really see like any encirclements I can go for. Bad, but it looks like we've got more troops than they do. Can we get there? No, we can't get over there to fight them navally, though I think they would win anyways. Oh shit, okay. Oh, did I have ordered my fighters? Air superiority. I'm trying to think of ways to do a pincer maneuver here, but the problem is these mountains, like, if I tell my troops to attack through, I maybe should have put everything into a spearhead towards Bucharest. This may be a mistake. Let's halt the advance here. Let's halt the advance. And I'm gonna cancel all orders. Do I want to do that? No, I don't. I want to delete. This line is deleted, and that is narrower. Yeah. Because we don't want to bother attacking through the mountains. That makes more sense. I just want to delete the whole line. Can I not do that? Okay, so that pushes through, and then these guys have as their second offensive line there as well. international focus. We need more infrastructure. Oh, I just take a sip of the tea. Oh, there's too much milk in this tea. Yeah, I don't like that. But I've got bigger problems than over-lactated tea. Okay, so we don't want to attack through that province. I need to get that out of the line of attack. I just want that. Drawing tool, man. There. I don't want to attack through the mountains. And I think if we just hold the front line with them, we'll be all right, because I think they're undersupplied. See details. Oh, 21 to 50. Oh, I don't think we can win this. If they're at the top of that. Oh, shit. Meanwhile, we're down to three men, so we're gonna have to go into extensive conscription. And we're running out of... Well, this will be a learning experience if I lose. I should have... Because we were communist and they were democratic, we were mobilizing faster, world tension was still reasonably low. But actually, it wasn't low. You know, Japan was giving them stuff to... giving them some tension to build on, so... I don't know what I could have done better. Maybe better military divisions? Took the military divisions I had, made them larger? That's definitely an idea. It looks like we're winning most of these, so let's restart the attack, see if we can win this out here. It just doesn't look good, though, does it? I'm not used to defeat lately in this game, but I think I've just overestimated what is possible with Yugoslavia early in the game. I should have picked on an easier target. If I'd picked on Bulgaria, I think I'd be over to the ocean by now. The sea, rather. And then I'd have that, you know, that sea corridor there would be enough for Russia to ferry me troops in a war as well, so. That might be helpful. So you're attacking through there. He's reassigning those. Yeah, it does need to do that, though, because the flank isn't doing so well. I guess I could have gotten conscription up higher and thus gotten more troops. And we were pushing into... Oh, no, we haven't. Have we pushed into any... No, we haven't pushed into a single Romanian province yet. Damn. Feels like we got one. I guess not. Oh, there we go. We got one. I mean, if we can break them... Oh, no, don't do that. Oh. Okay, you're not attacking through there. You should be it. Oh no, we can't attack into those guys. That's a pretty good set of troops right there. He's just trying to realign the front all the time. That's the problem with having two generals. Look at all that. Oh, the AI. Maybe if I'd micromanaged it myself, I would have gotten a little bit better of a result, because not everything's moving all the time, but then I might have gotten actually pincered out of this stuff quicker. But those divisions there are eventually going to screw us over big time. The real question is, do they not have the political power to keep up with us in terms of population? But they're still mobilizing. Look at that. They're still mobilizing. Ooh, new troops for us, though. It's a territory hills. Let's cancel the attack because there's a storm going on right now. Wait out the weather. This is micromanagement for you. Not taking any attrition, otherwise I'd get the attrition guy. Oh, it looks like they're breaking through. Okay. Okay, do we go full YOLO? I think we go full YOLO. But we need to get this new division into there so that they don't get pushed back. Oh, I think this just might be a bridge too far. Or Romania too far. Yeah. What do we got in production? We're all right. How are we doing logistically? Oh man, we're not gonna be able to keep this up very long. They're gonna outproduce us in the end. Yes, drastically outproduce us. Should I cancel production of these guys? I don't want to yet. Are my armies still supplied? It's gonna get dodgier if I keep building troops. Let's cancel the ones without any supplies. Those guys are almost done. So we redistribute this stuff to the currently fighting troops. Okay, it looks like our luck's increasing. Execute the plan. Execute the plan. Okay, I don't think they're going to be able to stand up in the long run. I think they're running out of manpower. That's interesting. I guess it's because they're a democracy. Are there any manpower supplies or something? Because when that southern division there wears down, I think we've got a more or less straight road to Bucharest. At which point we can knock them out of the war. But this northern flank scares me. I don't know what to do. I think I gotta leave it as is. Are my plans doing alright? Yeah, this feels like a really simple war, and I should be micromanaging more, but I can't really see what to do. The terrain is a big problem here. Like, that mountain kind of screwed up my whole plan. I probably shouldn't have attacked through here at all. Should have just tried to spearhead through. Or, I could have taken Bulgaria first. And then Romania might have gotten guaranteed by Germany, but I don't know. Oh, this is not going to go well at all. Halt the advance. Damn it. No, they're well into our territory. By what, one province? Yeah, I don't think we can cope. And I forgot how much an advantage we had as Romania compared to the other starting powers around us, which is probably why I was able to do so well early on. Oh well, if this doesn't work, I will restart, and we will pick an easier target for our initial aggression. Is Romania fascist now? No, still democratic. I guess they just start with quite a few more divisions than Yugoslavia, and quite reasonably, well, not reasonably, but still superior quality troops. I don't remember having to research artillery as Romania, as Romania at the start. Whereas here, I think we were in quite a state. Can I attack through there? No, that's not going to be an attack. Risky right here. Is this gonna work? I think my superior strategy may have worked. So they're now panicking a little bit because we're pushing straight through onto Bucharest. GG. That looks like a GG right there. Nah, it's too aggressive. I'm playing on too high speed. I should be micromanaging that. Okay, you. Oh, everyone's attacking somewhere. Crap, I shouldn't have let that happen. Should not have let that happen. That's really sloppy. Oh, meanwhile, we're pushing them back elsewhere. So we lost that one division, but I think they've lost about as much. There's a new recruit to join the carnage. I wish you could turn it on so you could see what was... Okay, we've got the front line back to where we wanted it. We're pushing in. What's the actual war score? More of them have died than us. 45 divisions. We are in a status quo. It's a lot of killing for a status quo. I think this is definitely doable if you're more talented at the game than I am. If I had played smarter, micromanaged this, and had given myself more time to build up once going communist, I think I would have had a better time of it. Though, really, I think the simpler solution is just to go for Bulgaria. Sofia, the capital's right on the border. If you just strike straight at it, you'll knock them out the war real quick. That was definitely the better option. And then, who knows, after taking Bulgaria with more experienced troops and a few more divisions, you can turn around and then take Bucharest, because then you've got a much better front along the south of the country rather than the border with Yugoslavia, where you've got to fight through the Carpathians. So that may make more sense in the future. Oh shit! That's pocketed, but wait. How'd they get pocketed there? Why would you do that, AI? How? I didn't... Oh, God, that's terrible. Everyone attacked there. How did that happen? That's awful. Oh, God, this is going so bad. I'm not playing well today. Well, I have no excuse for this kind of incompetence. Construction effort. Liberty ethos. Ideological fanaticism. We need to break through there and reunite the front with those troops if we can. If we can't, I think the war is lost if we lose all three of those divisions. I can't see us recovering from that. However, on the other hand, if we drive them back, I think we're in a pretty good position. What's the supply situation like for these guys? Yeah, they are out of supply. But they're well equipped, so if we can break through here... In the meantime... God, they're going full YOL. full YOLO. Straight. Well, I did give them a YOLO order, so I can't complain. What I should be doing is playing better. You through to there. I think we're gonna break through. Yes! Awesome. Hey, they're really weakening now. They do so well up here because they've got these mountain brigades that just do so well in the hills here. But once we get on the open fields, our block standard infantry with the RT do way better. I think I definitely could have played this better, but I think we're going to win. I have some hope. Low manpower now, we're fine. Aura's still in status quo. Oh, they are really losing. They are losing men now, though. They're 32 or 25. I'm sure they've raised conscription, but Romania doesn't have that many troops early on either. And the fact their casualties are higher is a good sign. I'm going to halt the attack for a little bit to let the troops realign where the AI thinks they need to be. I think that's a reasonably good way of dealing with the AI. Because sometimes they need to kind of pause the attack to realign troops. And what people do is they just keep the attacks going with the troops aligned the way that they were. Whereas you need to give them time to get what they want out of troop movement. What to do? I've got a bucket load of political power, so I'm gonna get. Is there anything I can get that would actually help my men? Yes, chief of army. Yeah. Division attack rate. Theorist. Army experience gained daily. Yeah. Oh man, communists get so much political power. It's great. I should have really used all that much sooner and more aggressively. I'll note that. I don't think I've played a communist faction before. So all the political power stuff is really interesting. They get more political power than fascists, but less bonuses. As opposed to democracies, which get nothing. Really. Better consumer goods? Let's restart the attack. And because we're winning, I'm going to put them on a little less aggressive than I was before. I don't want them getting flanked now. We're so close, I think, to winning this shebang. And man, if we manage to take out all of Romania, we're going to be in a pretty good position. If we can finish this war, that's the thing. If we can finish the war before we get pulled into something else that we don't want to be a part of. How are we doing in terms of logistics? We're pretty bad. It's pretty bad. But I think we'll hold on. Oh, political commissions, division recovery rate. Oh, that's what commissars do. Commissars shove more men into the fight. Makes sense. That's actually a pretty decent ability. It's better, though, if you were playing a country with a lot of manpower, which we aren't distinctly not. I just hope we can end this war before the whole world war kicks off and we get drawn in. That's what I hope. Will Russia a joint faction? No. Must be neighbor. World tension 8. Yugoslavia is a player 20. Yugoslavia's at war. Okay, so if we weren't at war, we would be literally about to be able to join their faction. We'd be 1 point short, but because we're at war, we're way short. What are we doing production-wise? I just think I should have spent more time recruiting divisions. I would have made a been a distinct advantage. Okay, you're not doing anything because you don't have an attack line. I want you just to do a simple offensive line into there and attack. I think we want to keep up the pressure on their defenses as much as we can. Slot available. Do you want to get resource gain efficiency? Is that really worth it for us? Factory repair speed. We're going to need that, but not yet. I think it's better to get an actual fighter plane. People's Republic of China has capitulated by 1939. God, Super Japan is always Super Japan. I mean, that might be historical, but I don't think it was. I think China held out a lot longer than that. Oh, more divisions. Okay, we can get a full on juicy encirclement here and in this war. All right. You. Yeah. And you. Okay, we're not going to get the juicy encirclement. I bet the war's not going status quo now. Construction effort and 2 civilian factories. It's worth getting that now. I probably should have gotten that much earlier before the war started for the increased experience. What are Romanian casualties at now? Oh, we've caught up to them a little bit, I think, since last time. 48 divisions to there. They're probably on the better side of 30. I think we outnumber them now. And I think we've got better combat width. Let's check how that's going, actually. Soft attack. Okay, they've got... That's a good division there. 32-35 versus 38-38-40-40. Whoa, they've got much better defense. What's that from? From experience. And commander skill. Most of that is due to terrain, enemy air superiority. Wait, where are my fighters? Fighters. Okay. They're over here. Dudes, get over. Where, have we captured an airfield yet? I don't think we have. Okay. So we suck on defense, so we need to keep attacking. Is that how that works? Or is it... I don't know whether your attack modifiers... Oh yeah, breakthrough versus defense. So yeah, it's not like the defense modifier counts when you're fighting, it's breakthrough. And we're... Yes! We are through. We are gonna be so out of people by the end of this bloody war. We're going to have to go to service by recruitment. I don't want to do that yet. I don't want to do that until the very last second. Because it hits us so hard. I said nothing compared to the bonus we're going to get from actually properly controlling Romania. If this war ends before the cluster screw-up that will be World War II starts. What's Germany doing? Well, we don't know their focus. I mean, heck, Germany just could invade us right off the bat before we can join the Comintern. This war has lasted far, far longer than I wanted. Okay, they've done Memel. They're probably going to Danziger War now. Or they're going to do one thing, and then they're going to do Danziger War after that. Bucharest is ours. Free military factories. Cool. Um, the new front line for this guy is just going to be to take the coast. And this guy, well, he's still fighting. What? How is it still a status quo? I've got their goddamn capital. That's crazy. I've got your capital. Oh, they're almost out, though. 90% towards capitulation. Okay, just keep going, guys. This guy, edit mode. Okay, I think we got this. I'm just gonna speed this up now. Make sure we don't run out of troops. I really hope I can end this war before we run out of troops, and I've got to click the, conscript more peoples button. Actually, the one way to avoid that is to not train more troops while we're low on men. So I'll let those two, I'll let those three finish up. After this, I'm gonna get that because I can convert those to military factories as well. Hopefully in the gap between this war and then the war with Russia. Playing Romania too much. The war with the Germans. Let's see if this can end. I'm actually gonna call this video here. It's been a good one. Thank you for watching. If you enjoy, please like, comment, and all that good stuff.